Have one?
We have ours.
We're not now, yes.
Oh, okay. So it says what are the cars that were supposed to?
Where's your group?
Right here.
Are you supposed to be working with this man? You can hear everything they say?
She has.
I
I asked one was,
Oh, balance.
So if you go with the flex, go ahead and go to the back.
Did you guys take pictures? Do you need another? Okay.
I'm going to go to the next one.
so here's what's going to happen. So here's what's going to happen. I need your help a little bit because I wanted to see how things go in a different direction for me based on what you guys, the feedback that I've kind of gotten from you a little bit. So what's going to happen is I'm going to go through, we're going to have kind of a short day as far as lecture goes, but what I want you to do is take out a scrap of paper, put everybody's name on it, and then I want you to put these in order so that you will actually hand this in to me before you leave today. Now, you're not getting any points for it. You're not getting any points taken away. It's just as a guide for me to figure out whether doing more anatomy and stuff in class is going to be the way to go. Okay? So if the first one is number 7, put number 7 in the first one. The second one is number 22, put 22 to the second one. Just kind of your sheet of paper. So I know what order those are going to go.
No.
Part of it, like I said, it's going to be a short day.
I
can get into this, give me some more time. Part of why I'm wanting to do this is I have looked at the pre-class exercises and the quizzes that you guys have been doing. I wasn't really happy with some of the scores, only because I think that sometimes you're doing them because you're going to get points regardless of what you do. So I'm trying to get an idea of maybe the lack of anatomy and physiology is contributing to part of the concern that students have had. It's also some of the pathophysiology that I think that we're missing from the course. So I'm going to be concentrating a little bit more time on that, hopefully next semester, which is part of the reason for the questions on the other side of your workshop. Okay?
When you're looking at the quizzes,
did you get these right at least?
Yes. Well, when you're looking at the quizzes, do you check over as far as the type in answers? Because if I put bronchioles instead of bronchial, it'll mark it incorrect. Do you care? Obviously,
it doesn't make any difference to me.
So you peek though, and you see that you have them correct. Okay.
Even the tachycardia, you don't have bladder.
Yeah. All right, so what are the four functions of the respiratory system? Who wants to do number one? Everybody?
We can start.
I'm sorry?
We can start with number one.
Oh, okay.
It warms air.
Okay, that's one. Warms the air. And how does it do that?
Breathing in, there's a lot of blood vessels in your nose, and then the air gets in contact with the mucous membranes that's rich in a lot of blood vessels, and then you get a heat transfer and warm the air that way.
So body temperature is going to be a big deal, right? That's going to kind of determine whether or not we're going to be able to warm the air when we breathe it in, okay? What about number two? Nobody? Go ahead.
It allows you to to speak.
A little bit louder.
Allows you to speak.
Okay. Why is that important?
The air goes over the vocal cords.
Okay.
So you can communicate with people.
Okay. Number three? One more time. Remove waste like what? Anything else? If you get some junk in your lungs, what are you going to do? You're going to cough it out. So it's just not carbon dioxide we're going to kind of get rid of. Remember the cilii in the respiratory tract, it kind of waves up to get some of those things out. Does that sound familiar?
No.
So if we have stuff in there that we can't get out, what's going to happen? They're going to develop what?
Pneumonia.
So what kind of drugs are we going to give them?
Antibiotics.
Anti-infectives, mostly probably antibiotics, depending on what it is. If you've got fluid and stuff trapped into your lungs, and you can't cough it out, even though it may not necessarily be a bacteria, suppressing that stuff and keeping it in there could set up a pneumonia. Do you remember the three things that pathogens need to survive inside the body?
Moisture, heat, and darkness.
Warm, dark, moist. It needs those three things. Those are the optimal environments that they work in. Is it warm, dark, and moist inside your lungs?
Yes.
There you go. All right, what about the last one? Nobody? Oh.
Oh, it delivers oxygen to the cells.
Guys, can you listen, please? Sorry. What was the last one, sorry?
It delivers oxygen to the cells in the body.
Is that important?
Yeah.
And what happens if your body isn't able to do that?
Can
you think of a condition that we might have a problem with that?
asthma.
Asthma. So what happens in asthma?
You have constriction of the bronchi, and then you don't get the optimal oxygen delivery.
Is it necessarily obstruction or?
Constriction.
Oh, constriction. So the bronchioles get constricted. So what are we going to do to fix that? We're going to give a bronchodilator so we can open it back up again. And there's a couple different ways that we can do, a couple different medications that we can utilize to do that with. Do you remember seeing any of your bronchodilators when you did your reading and stuff? Sinuses, who gets colds in the winter? Everybody, I'm like prone to them for some reason. It's like, as soon as the snow hits, I've got them. Wasn't there a, what was the first famotidine? Was it histamine receptor, right? So when we take famotidine, for the histamines in the antihistamines that we have for our seasonal allergies. Yes, it's kind of like a oh, you're pregnant, yes or no? It's not a maybe. So histamine is an H?
Two.
What?
Antagonist.
It's an H1. So when we talk about famotidine, we're talking about an H1. When we talk about some of the bronchial stuff, we're talking about what?
H2.
H2. They're totally different receptors. So taking your Benadryl, if you have asthma, isn't going to help you. And that's where you kind of need to start thinking about some of the differences and stuff. Okay? Which side of the lungs only has two lobes?
Left.
Why?
Heart.
Because of what?
The heart.
Does it make a difference when you're listening to lung sounds?
Yes.
So you're only going to listen twice on one side and three on the other side? No, because why? Because even though it's got two lobes, you're still going to have the bases down here at the bottom. So even though those two lobes, you're still going to go one, two, and three on the back so that you can hear them. You guys have done lung sounds assessments in 211? All right. What's the difference between crackles, rails, bronchi, and wheezes? Let's start at the beginning. Crackles, what is that? What is it? One more time, please.
Oh, high-pitched breath sounds that are similar to popping or snapping.
So what's that going to tell you?
There's fluid in the lungs.
And so what are we going to do to fix it? This is kind of what I'm wanting you to kind of get to the point that we can go. So identify with the anatomy, identify when things go wrong, and then identify what drugs we're going to utilize to fix it, the nuance of the drugs. I'm sorry, I need to cut you off.
Oh, no, that's okay. Like encourage coughing and then spirometer, stuff like that.
Okay.
Unless it's more like a fluid in the lungs because you have pneumonia or an infection, then antibiotics and other.
Okay. What about number eight? What's number two? How about Rails? What's that? Is any of this in your pathophysiology book?
Fluid in the lungs.
Second one is what? What did I say it was? Rails? What does that mean? What about bronchi? What's that? here, I mean, do you have like audios of these things that gets played in 211 so that you can like hear the differences between them and stuff like that? Some people are saying yes, some people are saying no. All right, so what about Wankai? What is that?
Gurgling or bubbling.
Okay, due to what?
Fluid.
Secretions in the airway.
So when somebody has Wankai, what are you going to do? After you listen to their lung sounds, what's the next step?
Productive cough.
You're going to have them cough. And see if the things can get loosened up in there. So you have them cough and see if there's anything productive that's coming out. They don't necessarily have to cough it out of your mouth, but just to see if it's moved around. And then you listen to the lung sound again to see if it's improved it. If it's not, what are we probably going to do? What kind of drugs are we going to be thinking about?
Expectorant.
I'm sorry?
Expectorant drugs.
Probably antibiotics. There's some kind of infection because we need what? Warm, dry, moist for things to grow in the lungs. So we're going to do antibiotics next week. But that's kind of what I want you to be thinking about when you run across these things. What about reasons? What's that? This is the sign-in sheet? Oh, I was going to do it off the sheet you handed in, but that's okay. What about wheezes? What do we do for wheezes? What does wheezes mean?
It's high-pitched sound produced by narrow airways, and we usually give bronchodilators, like albuterol.
Can it be the upper airway or the lower airway or both?
It can be both.
It can be both. You ever heard anybody that sounds like I'm going to cough if I do that too much? What does that tell you?
Airway obstruction.
They're having problems getting air into their lungs. Now that can be due to a couple of different things. One of the things you said was asthma, which what we're going to do then is think about giving them a bronchodilator. So we got a bunch of different respiratory diseases. First one is asthma. Anybody have asthma? Anybody in here have asthma? I thought maybe you'd show me your halo thing. Bronchitis, anybody have that? What's bronchitis? Inflammation of the bronchi. So when bronchi get inflamed, what does that mean? Are we going to be able to have air exchange? What are your lung sounds going to sound like? They kind of that wheezing sound, right? It's just like the, you ever blow over like a bottle of soda or a water bottle, you know, and you get that like kind of whistling sound. And you know, like if you do a very small bottle versus a big bottle, your pitch is going to be a little bit different. So bronchitis is common in smokers, called chronic bronchitis. What about pneumonia? Have you heard of pneumonia? This is something you're going to see quite often when you go to the hospital. What are we going to do? The first thing we want to do is to listen to their lungs and see if they can cough anything up. If they can cough something up, what are we going to do with it?
We're going to
send it to the lab to see if it's an infectious agent. So yes, there will be times when you're going to give your patients a specimen cup and say, cough into the cup. And then they're going to end up sending that down to the lab. What's going to be the next step? Once we find out what the infectious agent is, what's going to be the next step? Try them on some kind of anti-infective, probably an antibiotic. We'll talk about that next week as well. Pulmonary edema, what does that mean? We talked about the difference between inflammation, swelling, and edema last week, or maybe the week before. Do you remember the difference between the three? Edema basically means fluid in the lungs. Okay, because edema is where that buildup of fluid. Remember, and they had the pitting edema in their feet, you push the finger on it. Remember that at all? Okay, so this is basically a buildup of fluid. What kind of drugs are we going to give this person?
Diuretic.
Maybe a diuretic? Getting rid of some of the fluid? What about an antibiotic?
Unless the infection is
spread. Well, number one, you said no. Why not?
Well, it depends. Is the edema caused by an infection? If yes, figure out what infection, then treat. If no, then you wouldn't treat it with antibiotics because there's no infection.
Good answer. Everybody want to say yes, you would? I do. Warm, dark, moist. If I've got fluid in my lungs, am I going to be trapping something, the potential of trapping something in my lungs? So you're going to start on some kind of a simple antibiotic. And then once the results come back, you can either stop it and or switch them to something else. So you're still going to end up getting a spectrum. Atelectasis? Where an area of the lungs is not getting oxygen. I don't want you to think collapsed lung, but this is usually due to some kind of a blockage. And it could be, you know, like a glob of snot or something like that. You can actually see this on an x-ray. I should have done a picture of that. Emphysema, what is that?
Happens when you lose the elasticity of the alveoli.
Exactly. So what's going to happen here? What's the big thing here? Out of the four things that we have for the respiratory system,
gas exchange will be affected.
What are we going to do to that?
Supplemental oxygen,
if
I need it.
What about anti-inflammatories? Lung cancer, that one's kind of a completely different thing. We don't get into the anti-cancer drugs in this course. Probably thank goodness for you, because it's really complicated. And then pulmonary embolism. You heard of that? You should have this on your slides. So pulmonary embolism is what?
Blood clot in the lung.
A what?
Blood clot in the lung.
Is it always a blood clot?
No.
What else could it be?
Air.
What is it?
Air. You have an air.
Greenhouse.
Greenhouse.
How about fat? Yeah, someone said that. Sorry. Fat embolisms. They're uncommon, but they can happen. Typically when you break a large bone, like a femur, it's not uncommon that the fat globules go into the bloodstream and get carried up into the lungs. All right, albuterol. Why don't we take a break?
No,
I think you are.
We'll get marked down if you're talking about the company.
To raise their hand. I'm not going to split you up this time.
Raise your hand.
Anybody over here?
I was about to.
At least one person. I'm just trying to assign, I'm going to assign drawings. That's what I'll be here tomorrow. Back on Memphis Zone. I'm teleclassed. Mentometer. The Alpha Land. So what I'm going to do, it's the same thing that I did last time, is I'm going to go through and start asking you questions about the drug, just like you would kind of see on your exams. So look at your drug cards, start going through and thinking about some of the exam questions type things that you might see, and then we'll go through them as a class. Okay.
Okay, so, what? I